Welcome to my 2015 reading and booktube goals. This is everything that I want to try and do in 2015 concerning reading and everything that I do here on booktube. So, first on the list, my 2015 reading goals. My Goodreads reading goal. Last year I was very impressed because I hit 108 and my goal was 100. Now, originally I was going to use the 108 as this year's goal, but I decided I've got some other stuff that I probably should be doing, so I'm gonna lessen my goal a little bit. So I'm gonna do a goal of 75 books for 2015. 5 writing books. I am a writer. I should be constantly improving my craft, but I have yet to actually read an entire writing book. I'm gonna read 5 this year. I only know of 2 that I actually really want to read, so the other 3 are to be determined, but the 2 that I know I'm gonna read is Save the Cat by Blake Snyder, which is technically a screenwriting book, but it works for writing novels too, and Stein on Writing by Sol Stein. I've read pieces of it. I gleaned a lot of this information to use in my Nano Edmo videos in December of 2013. For all of you who watched those, it was about improving writing and editing your writing, so I learned a lot of great information from that, and I really need to read the rest of the book. Thus, it's currently holding my favorite bookmark. Don't you forget about me. Star Wars books. It was one of my goals last year to read a ton of Star Wars fiction to prepare for the next Star Wars movie, which I thought was coming out this summer, but it's actually coming out this December. So I have an entire whole year to read tons of Star Wars fiction. I'm gonna start with all of Timothy Zahn's Thrawn series. I just realized yesterday as I was putting them together in Goodreads lists that there's like 3 different series. 1 Brandon Sanderson novel. Not one of his YA books, but like one of his actual adult-sized books. The books that a friend of mine likes to joke has chapters the size of normal books. I'm kind of intimidated by the size, but we're gonna do it. I am finally going to read Harry Potter and the Sorcerer's Stone, hopefully with some awesome newbie reaction videos. You heard me right, newbie. I've never read Harry Potter. Let the outcry commence. Catch up on the Skullduggery Pleasant series by Derek Landy. I know you'll be happy to hear that, Georgina. Finish 1 manga series. Manga. Manga? Manga. I've heard it both ways. Manga, manga. Drum roll, please. On Goodreads, I have put together a 2015 TBR list. This is a bunch of the books that I was going to read last year, but I never really got around to it. So I've added all of those books into a list on Goodreads. I have added in a bunch more that I have just randomly found browsing at my library, just titles that I put on there so that I don't forget them. And each month, I'm going to pick at least 1 of those titles to read. So I'm gonna try and work my way through this TBR list. The last I looked at it, I think there are about 30 titles on there, so hopefully I will get around to reading more than 1 a month, but my goal is 1 a month, and we'll see how that goes. The good thing is that there's the books that I actually really want to read. It's not just books that I randomly have on my shelf that I just kind of want to say, oh, hey, I should read that. These are books that I am very anxious to read, so I'm gonna get around to them, I think. More browse selecting. If I'm at the library and I see a book that looks interesting and I want to read it, I'm just gonna take it. Join a book club. I really want to be a part of a book club, but I'm having a hard time finding a good one. I'd like to do one online so that I can get to know some more of the booktube people. But I'm having trouble finding one that reads books that I'm interested in, and one small enough where you're actually talking with people instead of at them. And starting my own didn't really work out at all. I am so sorry. On a completely random note, I'd like this guy to be in more videos. Maybe we'll play Find Coulson, you know, like Find Waldo, except for with my awesome Coulson bobblehead, because I am a total Coulson fangirl. And now, onto my 2015 booktube goals. More interaction. I'm going to watch more booktube videos and leave comments, and basically try to be more social. I would like to post one video a week. This is what I've tried to hold myself to and don't always succeed. So I would like to post a video every Thursday. Occasionally, I will probably post two, but one a week is my goal. More book to movie comparisons. I barely did any of these last year, and I'm really, really sorry. I know that I enjoy doing these. It was one of my favorite kinds of videos to do, and I didn't give myself enough time for them. So I am definitely gonna start doing more book to movie comparisons because I enjoy them and you enjoy them. More fun videos. I want to do more tags and bookish things like building book towers or playing bookish games. Because when I'm doing strictly reviews, I feel like I'm missing out on half of what makes booktubing so awesome. No more! Discussions, reactions, and fangirling. The downside to doing spoiler-free reviews means that I don't get to talk about the things that I really, really, really want to talk about that happened at the very end of the book. Don't worry, while I'm not going to stop doing spoiler-free reviews, I would like to do more videos where I get to talk about books with people who have actually read the books, and we get to discuss it and fangirl or fanboy over it and how awesome and amazing they are. This is what I really, really, really want to do. The book club goal. I want to do more videos where I actually get to talk about books. Yes, yes, more videos where I actually get to discuss the thing for which I'm doing videos for. I just want to talk about books. I had no idea we were going to do different personalities in this video. Books, 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 and more books. Books is the only thing that's gonna be here. Kid. Most of all, my goal for this year is to just have fun with the BookTube videos. Last year, it got kind of workish. I felt very pressured to do things that I was pressuring myself to do, and I really just want to let go and I want to have fun with it, because it's no fun if you consider it work. And so I just want to have fun, because you know what Cyndi Lauper says, girls just want to have fun. And now for my most anticipated books of 2015. So these are just the books that I know of at the moment that are coming out in 2015 that I really want to read. So there's probably more coming out next year that I want to read that I just don't know about or can't remember at this precise time. I was actually spending an hour earlier today on Goodreads trying to find all of the books that were coming out in 2015 and which ones I wanted to read. And then I realized, yeah, stop that, Amanda. You need to get this video done, like, now. First on the list is Firefight by Brandon Sanderson. This is book two of the Reckoner series, and it released on January 6th. I plan to get my copy very, very soon. Firefight. The Magician's Lie by Greer McAllister. I have only just heard about this book. I saw it advertised on Goodreads, and it said that it was, you know, along the lines of The Night Circus by Aaron Morgenstern, and that is just a no-brainer. So that book comes out on January 13th. Fairest and Winter by Marissa Meyer. Release dates on January 27th and November 10th, respectively. And who doesn't love The Lunar Chronicles? Oven by David Powers King and Michael Jensen. This book is set to release on January 27th. Dearest, of course, by Alethea Contis. Release date February 3rd. Third book of the Woodcutter Sisters series. Princess Academy Forgotten Sisters by Shannon Hale. This is the third book of the Princess Academy series, and while I've only read the first book so far, I loved it, and I'm really gonna need to catch up on them this year. And that's gonna be released on March 3rd. Stolen Magic by Gail Carson Levine. This is the sequel to A Tale of Two Cities, which is basically a fantasy story in a medieval kingdom with a dragon who is basically Sherlock Holmes and her girl assistant who is basically sort of Watson. And I found it completely brilliant and lovable, and so I cannot wait for the second book to come out because it's been years, absolute years. It's expected to release on April 21st. The Forever Man, book 3 of the Warp series by Owen Colfer. Release date June 23rd. Enemies and Endings by Shelby Bock. Book 4 of the Ever After series. It's the final book of the series. I'm not ready for this story to end. I love it so much. It's coming out June 30th, and I'm not ready. I am not ready for this story to end. Please don't end the story. Silver in the Blood by Jessica Day George. This book will be released on July 7th, and really all you need to know about it is that it's by Jessica Day George. Historical fantasy. Romania. I cannot wait for this book. I have loved every single one of Jessica Day George's books that I have read, although admittedly I have not read them all, so I really, really need to get on those this year as well. Last but not least, Ninja Librarian's Sword in the Stacks by Jen Swan Downey. This is the sequel to Ninja Librarian's The Accidental Key Hand, which I read and reviewed earlier this year, which was mind-boggling and brilliant and had all kinds of literary references, and there was time travel and there was sword fighting and there was action and it just had all of the things. Even like tons of Star Wars quotes. It literally had all of the things. All right, that is all from me for today. Look forward next week because I will be doing my top 14 books of 2014 video just as soon as I narrow down my top 14 from my top 22. This is Amanda signing out, and I will see you all next week. No, I'm just kidding. We're not really gonna do that.